All right, it is game time. It is long ball time. It is Daily Coppock time. How you doing, everybody? I'm Chet Coppock, Daily Coppock, brought to you by my great friends at Carmichael's, my favorite steakhouse, 1052 West Monroe Street, right here in the West Loop. The guy's ego is simply off the charts. He has the kind of personality that makes anybody who can't whip a spiral 65 yards feel like dirt.
In the wake of criticism regarding quarterback Jay Cutler's toughness, Chicago Bears coach Lovie Smith says the veteran signal caller suffered a sprained medial collateral ligament in his left knee during the first half of Sunday's NFC title game. Cutler suffered the injury late in the second quarter and tried to come back in the third before leaving the game for good. Current and former NFL players began to question Cutler's toughness on Twitter, not Coach Smith.
For guys to take a shot, they weren't there to try to look at his body language and figure out whether he was hurt because he was on the sideline or what I would do in that situation. You don't know what you would do in that situation.
Smith says had the Bears won the game, Cutler's availability for the Super Bowl would have been uncertain.
Now, knowing Jay Cutler, he probably thinks that the aftermath of the Bear-Green Bay Packer game is now a dead issue. The story is forgotten. Jay, I got news for you. If you don't get this cleared up, if you don't get public relations help, next year on opening day, if you get picked a couple of times and the Bears get knocked off, you will get booed worse than a tax increase. Here is the problem with Jay Cutler. Where is the public relations help? Why hasn't Cutler gone in front of a microphone to address the press and address the fans? You know, the people who pay the dough to buy tickets at Soldier Field. Cutler right now is screaming for public relations help. However, here is the question. Would Jay Cutler accept public relations help? Meanwhile, there is still plenty of room left on the Chicago Bulls bandwagon. Do you realize this ball club might just end the year? I kid you not, I'm on the square with this. This ball club just might end the year with a better record than LeBron James, D-Wade, Chris Bosh, and the Miami Heat.
At guard, 6'3", number one.
Chicago, it is, though.
Derrick Rose.
Yeah. Uh-huh, you know what it is. Mr. Everything I do it for the crib. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Unbelievable in transition.
Now, let's isolate on the point guard, Derrick Rose. In my opinion, Rose really has a two-guard mentality. He loves the jump shot. It's gotten better. It's improving. But you can't take Derrick Rose off the point for the obvious reason. The guy is such a magnificent penetrator. I will tell you one thing. There is no team in the NBA right now that wants to face the Chicago Bulls in the playoffs. All right. Welcome to Coppock's Motion Picture House. No, we are not talking about a piece of junk like Smokey and the Bandit. We are talking about the genius of Marlon Brando, the essence of Marlon Brando is Terry Malloy, a broken-down ex-fighter working the docks in New York City, battling his conscience and battling his brother as portrayed by Rod Steiger. You may have seen this scene before, but you know what? Coppock's going to take care of you. Coppock is going to give you a work.
Remember that night in the garden, you came down my dressing room and said, kid, this ain't your night. We're going for the price on Wilson. You remember that? This ain't your night. My night, I could have taken Wilson apart. So what happens? He gets the title shot outdoors in a ballpark, and what do I get? A one-way ticket to Palookaville. You was my brother, Charlie. You should have looked out for me a little bit. You should have taken care of me just a little bit so I wouldn't have to take them dives for the short end money.
Well, I had some bets down for you. You saw some money.
You don't understand. I could have had class. I could have been a contender. I could have been somebody instead of a bum, which is what I am. Let's face it. It was you, Charlie.
So what does sports really create besides overpriced tickets, overpriced beer, and from time to time, a sense of civic pride? With that in mind, it also creates great phraseology, great quotes, memorable calls. With that in mind, here is the all Coppock, all top five sports jargon, sports quote list. Number five, former Yankee catcher Yogi Berra discussing a restaurant. No one goes there anymore. It's too crowded. Number four, Russ Hodges, the 1951 National League playoffs, the Dodgers against the Giants. Number three, Yankee boss Casey Stengel. The key to managing is keeping the guys who hate your guts away from the guys who are on the fence. Number two, Al Michaels, 1980. The Miracle on Ice, Lake Placid, the Olympic Games. Do you believe in miracles? Yes.
5 seconds left in the game. Do you believe in miracles? Yes!
And number one, Mike Ditka on kickball. Quote, if God had wanted man to play soccer, he would have given us arms.
There's three quarterbacks on this football team. Whichever one starts, starts. Whichever ones don't, we'll back him up. Period. Cut and dried. It's nobody's concern but ours. Nobody's. Next.
Injuries from the game.
Talk to the trainer. Next.
They are, simply put, the best bar band of all time. Anytime you get the opportunity to check out George Thorogood and his tag team partners, do yourself a favor. It's a concert you don't want to miss. George, of course, best known for his 1982 classic, Bad to the Bone. As we close out this edition of the Daily Coppock, we want to remind you, don't forget to get your copy of Fat Guys Shouldn't Be Dancing at Halftime, my bestseller, released by Triumph Books. Also, check us out on Twitter. Check us out on Facebook. Let us know what you think about the Daily Coppock. Meanwhile, get your groove on. Get ready for some Bo Diddley Boogie. Here is George Thorogood and Who Do You Love? Catch you next time around. So long, everybody.
I walk 4 to 7 miles of barbed wire. I got a cobra snake for necktie. Pray in the house along the roadside. Made it a rattlesnake hide. Got a brand new kingdom. I'm a bit on top, and that's a made out of human skull. Come on, take a little walk with my honey and tell me who do you love? Love. Who do you love, honey? Ollie took the man by my hand, said, Lonesome George, you know, understand who.